Welcome to my show, Lest We Forget. Today we're going to look at Doctors of Madness. Yes, we have re-entered Weirdsville. However, there's some very interesting things that you need to know about this band, and I'll get to that. They are a Brit proto art rock band active for 3 years. It started in 75 and ended in 78. Coincidentally, the same 3 years that the Sex Pistols were active, but the Docs were not popular enough to achieve anything more than a cult following, but they are now seen as prime movers of the punk movement. They were first formed in 74 in Brixton in South London by singer-songwriter, guitarist Richard Strange, also known as Kid Strange, a performance artist who portrayed urban culture, neurosis, and systems of control. He led a band consistent of Urban Blitz on violin and lead guitar, Stoner on bass and vocals, and Pete Dilemma on drums and vocals. No, it wasn't East Coast Pete. Just another dilemma. The Docs cited the Velvet Underground and William S. Burroughs as their influence. The costumes, props, and makeup, backdrops, smoke, strobe lights, taped sound effects, and hard-to-describe avant-garde music provided for a show no one had ever heard or seen. There were three albums, Late Night Movies, All Night Brainstorms, and Figments of Emancipation, and Sons of Survival. After they broke up, due to losing the support of their label, and that was it. In the Unauthorized Guide to Punk Rock, the early English scene published in 2011, there was a new interest in the Doctors of Madness, and this prompted a re-release of their music on CD. Yay! There have been Madness shows in Japan in recent years. They reunited in 2014 for a one-off show as part of a Richard Strange project titled Language is a Virus from Outer Space. You know, I always suspected that. A tribute to satirist William S. Burroughs, Joe Elliott of Def Leppard also participated. A DVD titled In the Afterglow, it's a recording of an unplugged concert in Soho. Strange occasionally tours Japan, and he is a lecturer at Otaru University in Sapporo. And in 2019, Strange returned to the studio to record a Doctors of Madness album. Dark Times was released in September of 2019 on the Molecular Scream label. The critical acclaim was unanimous. Strange performs the songs of Lou Reed, keeping his music alive. I mean, keeping Lou Reed alive as well as Mr. Strange's music alive. That's the only way to keep your music alive is to, you know, go out and present it for people. And apparently, Japan is all over this band. Really, it's something like Pink Floyd opera or something. With more costumes, I guess. I don't know what they're singing about. I should probably look that up and tell y'all. It's probably not real pleasant, but it looks nice. It doesn't sound too bad either. You know, this is a band that was pre-punk. And that several, if not many, punk artists had their records in their collection, cite them as an influence. So, gotta be something to it, I guess, right? It's a little chaotic, yeah. Is there a method to the madness? I don't know, it looks like Harley Quinn right there. Is that Harley Quinn? Nah, she just looks like that. I don't think the Joker's in there, so. But see what I'm saying, like they did it back in the late 70s, and it's having repercussions all the way into 2020, so you can go out to the movies and see this stuff in the comic book movies that we all have come to love and appreciate. It's the same thing, right? What's so different? People dressing up in costumes, saying they have special powers. They got funny names, too. So anyway, this is my show, Lest We Forget, Doctors of Madness, and I'm sure that there's pretty much no one else out there who has a show on these guys, because I couldn't find much more information than what I shared with you. So if you all know something about this band and want to share it with me, I highly recommend you go down, hit like, and put a nice comment in there, and I'll see if I can read it and get some knowledge from you. Because right now, East Coast Beat is sorely lacking. See you next time.